One small step for man.
Did you ever want to be an astronaut, a freedom fighter, or a rock star? Using LENSA, you can create dozens of AI avatars with no technical knowledge in a matter of minutes. You will input your own images and you will get out a set of AI generated avatars. These will be of a mixture of quality, but some will be excellent. And much of it depends on the quality of images that you put in. Once you come into LENSA, you're going to tap on the top left hand corner. It says find magic avatars here. You need to upload up to 20 photos with a minimum of 10. It should be the same person on all photos and no other people on the photo. Selfies and portrait photos are what you need. So don't use long body shots. It's good to have a variety of backgrounds, a variety of facial expressions, and a variety of head angles. No photo shoots, because it's the same setting and this doesn't help the AI learn what you look like. What's your face like? You need lots of different situations. Snappy, snappy, snap, snap. No nudity. Keep those nipples under wraps, you know. Enslave the nipple in this instance. Otherwise, free it.
Free the nipple! Free the nipple!
So remember, the final results will highly depend on how strictly you follow the requirements. So it's time to start selecting your images. So go through and find up to 20 photos. It's really important here that you pick photos where you actually like how you look. Put a couple in of myself where I was a little bit like, oh, I've had a little glass of the vino there. I don't look my best. And it did not help with a few of these. This is because it takes an incredible amount of influence from individual photos to create the new avatars. So if there's one photo that you didn't like, it's going to create maybe 10 photos based exactly around that expression, that angle of yourself. And if you don't like it, it's just going to be 10 avatars wasted. Here are a couple of my examples that I have used. Then you have to select your gender. So I am a male. Gender is a construct. Sexuality is a fantasy. And diversity is impressed. Next up, we have to select what pack we would like. So you have three options here. And you have to pay for this, unfortunately. That is the little caveat, but it's fairly reasonable. It's roughly $2 for the smallest pack, $3 for the 100 image pack, and $4 for the 200 image pack. I would recommend the first time you run this that you pick a smaller pack to save some money. And then once you understand which images are working well, you can upload those again and redo it for a larger pack. You'll then have to sit back and wait whilst your images are uploaded to the server, processed by their computers, where the AI learns what you look like and it then generates your images. At the moment, I have a remaining timer for 20 minutes. You can notify yourself when it's done or just hide this screen. And then finally, you get your images outputted and you have different packs. You'll have superheroes, you'll have stylish versions of yourself looking very sexy, if I do say so myself. Oh, look, it's the sexy version of myself. Slightly more mystical, slightly more attractive, definitely more adventurous. Wow, this one's gave me a very large forehead. And you'll get a huge variety of yourself from anime to astronauts to adventure. It does give you different images if you are a woman as well. It has a different theme. And you can see that some of them are not excellent. This one doesn't really look like me. And there are some artifacts inside of the image, some peculiarities. And after this, you can save all your avatars at the top by clicking Save All Avatars. You can save in 4K or in standard resolution. That's it. And now you can get yourself a fancy new profile photo, an excellent Tinder update, or just something to sit back and dream you were. Ah. A couple of important things to note is you might be concerned about your photos being uploaded and given to this company. And the company behind LENSA AI is Prisma Labs. And they told TechCrunch that it uses AWS cloud services to process users' photos. As soon as an AI model is trained on a user's photos, the images are immediately deleted. I think these will explode in popularity in the next couple of weeks, and everyone on your newsfeed will be having a new fancy profile photo. There is a huge appeal to these photos. The fact that it creates a better version of yourself is extremely arousing. I mean, I believe that we all want to be fully, deeply in love with ourselves. And in some ways, this allows us to see ourselves from our best sight. It's bringing AI to the masses in an easy to use way, which allows us not to have to fiddle about with a perhaps overwhelming and complicated
web UI of Stable Diffusion where we have to train our own models, but it's taking a very coherent, clear user experience and giving us excellent results. But now, don't trust any attractive photo you see of a human. Actually, you should never have done that anyway. But it's time to live our best lives in AI. It's time to look delightful. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you're interested in learning how to create your own AI art using Midjourney, which I think is the most advanced AI art generator, you can check out my courses in the description below. I'm Samson Vols. This is Delightful Design. Have a delightful day.
I come up here, I play, I'm showing me banjo for you.
Oh look, it's the sexy version of myself. Slightly more mystical, slightly more attractive, definitely more adventurous. Katniss, kiss me. I'm sexy now. Quickly, Katniss, kiss me.